Hello viewers, I'm SB and welcome back to Endless Legend. I'm wondering if Purple is planning to attack us or what is going on here. He has an army here, it's probably 4 to 6 troops. He has an army here that's 4 troops. I'm wondering, like, what are these guys doing? Right, because this is the same position that we killed an army in earlier. Why does he feel it's so important to run troops through my territory? What is on the other side that he's trying to get to? Seems very strange to me. Okay, so we have a lot of things going on here. Number one is we need to keep expanding. Chadun is almost done with a settler. Number two is we need to get some retrofits going, and we're very short dust. No, neither of the rangers are retrofitted either, so that means that we need about 400 dust. We are not bringing in dust fast enough for this. So the Empire Mint here will definitely help. We could send somebody north in the hopes of finding more ruins. I'd be reticent to send a small group of people north. It should probably be a real army, because there's actually a lot of fighting to do. There's a lot of neutrals that have spawned by this point. When we settle in Frida, are we going to gain a lot of dust? Yeah, if I settle here, which was the plan, this is actually a pretty high dust area, thanks to the anomaly. And the city will have four population upon founding, which will be very helpful in converting citizens to dust as well. So that'll actually help us get the retrofit on. I'm always a little gun shy about early war. More than I should be. The music is hitching for some reason. That's strange. Well, it's nothing to do about it this turn. But I'm concerned. Maybe we should turn this army toward these guys and attack them while they're still in range of the city. Okay, no, this is a very small... I cannot figure out what Purple is doing. If we attacked here, we'd get to include our city, but he wouldn't get to include his city. So this is going to be the plan. But our hero's in the wrong city. He would not currently be included in that. That's weird. I clicked a new army and the camera leapt to the top right. My computer's having some kind of problem. How are we doing on influence? We're at 128. If I were... like... there's no way we get to 200. We can pull this. This is pretty high value. This is usually... 25 approval is usually plus 15% science, but also plus 15% everything else, and I think it's usually better than doing this thing. If it moves you up a tier, it's pretty fantastic. And for us, it would move us up a tier, at least as things stand right now. So I'm just trying to figure out how much influence we have to play with here. We have an Empire plan coming up in 5 turns. So I'm thinking maybe this city doesn't get founded yet. Maybe we wait until after we do the Empire plan and then put it down. Well, even without the hero, though, I think we should do a good job killing these guys. Let's go ahead and spend on the retrofit for as many units as we can afford prior to challenging Purple. And we're going to keep trying to kill Purple's soldiers when we have vastly superior odds. I'll do this quickly before anybody moves into reinforcement range. Okay, good. Yeah, you better run. I just can't figure out what he's doing. Which makes me nervous. Is there something incredibly obvious that I'm missing here? Alright, so Karandar will gain some resources when it expands, although none of it will be money. Chadun's about to gain us some money. We need a little under 300 dust to complete the retrofit. Also, we're very close to having meritocratic promotion up. So I think I'm going to eat the temporary dust penalty here. of having two armies on the map, and let's start moving toward the ruins so that we can complete the quest as soon as possible. He's probing us, he's looking for weakness. I really cannot tell what he's doing. Okay, so we could put up the museum. 12 turns with none of our citizens devoted to industry really is not terrible timing. I don't love how long it's going to take for us to even get to the megapole. Do we have... Okay, we have another source of glass steel in the region we're about to settle. I think, sadly, you are just going to sit there for 3 turns, which means we could have delayed the build by 3 turns and made buildings instead. So I could just make a settler. Because we really do need to spread out. Like, there's a lot of territory that we would love to take over. Where would we build here? I think building right on top of the spiral rock peel looks pretty strong. Doesn't give us access to a lot of forest, but we can expand out into forest. And this is the area that has the tightest group of resources, I think. If we wanted to take this region... It's a little bit less obvious where to settle here. There's only one anomaly. So obviously you want to settle near that, but... This is a real bad settle. I hate settling on the border. So I guess you would settle here and then try to expand into the forest? I don't know. Anyway, let's, I think let's build a settler. Right? It's not another military unit? It might be another military unit, actually. Maybe we should keep prepping for war. Now, we gotta grow. We lost the last game by not being large enough, basically. We gotta keep growing. So... Oh, we have another glass steel deposit right here as well. Let's get that. Now, the cult is probing us. 62 attack, 49 damage on cavalry. What is the armor value? We have only 40 defense on our even on our upgraded troops, so that's not totally ideal. Alright, we're 2 turns off of pushing the Empire quest forward. Religious fervor is fantastic. I wish that had happened a couple turns earlier. How are we looking for our Empire plan here? If I wanted to do this, I'd have to get 170. This would be 200. Can we do 200? We're going to get 2 more pays. So actually, yeah, we can. We just have to move... we need 43. So we just need to move like a couple of people onto industry. Oops, not 4 people. Yeah, this will get us 203. So I can... No, I can't pull one of them back because... Each one of those guys is producing 4. Okay, yeah, so this will get us the big Empire plan that we want. We're definitely going to need the approval, because I'm going to bomb our approval through this rapid expansion plan. Oh yeah, I suppose we should research things, fair enough. We could pursue peace with the cultists, at least temporarily, and then maybe do a common enemies thing. We should probably get... Well, hold on. If it's taking us 8 turns to research things, we should probably get the alchemy workshop. And then the central market. We're going to expand quickly, so we need our approval buildings. Yeah, I know. It's not an exciting time to be that settler. He just has to sit there for a while. Flees immediately into purple territory. Generally speaking, parking your units in another player's territory leads to leads to some diplomatic problems. We gotta watch for purple declaring war on blue. In fact, we should check and see if purple has already declared war on blue, because like I said before, it's important to us that blue serve as a buffer for now and that they serve as our city in the future. Alright. It might be better for us to go to war with blue instead of purple, if we're given, you know, our choice of targets. 4 ranged and 2 minor faction. Oh, and the Wildwalker's hero has to be equipped, yep. Silly me. Okay, there we go. What happened? Somebody got attack 10 armies in order to gain this reward. Who got it? It was Pink. Okay, so whoever Pink is, they're warlike, and they're probably winning. Alright, make sure there's no enemies in Chadhun. Might be tricky. Okay, I definitely think this is a good play. And now we'll plop this city down. So it's turn 40 and we just got the ability to make... to actually put a boat in the water. It's not totally ideal. Okay. We need 284. I mean, we should retrofit when we can afford to retrofit. Take advantage of the fact that it pushes our army score up. And now let's go take a look at Dorius and see if it is possible for us to push purple a little bit. And we should make some military units. We have a couple of turns of our hero being devoted to the army before his assignment cooldown is back up, so we may as well use this time to push him in his military role. Oh, that's an enemy that we have to kill for our quest. Never mind. Okay, not quite a full garrison, and also not really very high fortification. Dorius might be vulnerable. Somebody has gotten 2,000 influence, that's green. We do have to try to get out into the rest of the world, right? Like, we've seen what happens when we isolate ourselves for too long. Actually, it looks like they might just come to us. I might not have to spend any movement on this. Alright, now we are going to ruffle Blue's feathers if we settle Ishimlor, and nobody else is really threatening to settle it, so I think we maybe can wait on that. And maybe this region should be our next settle. Please produce Takari Rangers. Oh, you guys don't have to do this anymore. Well, actually, hold up. In 2 turns, we're going to have enough resources that we could make a dash for the Megapole. Actually, if we don't build this guy, we can do it next turn. So why don't we just put 1 turn of work into a burrow. And then we'll try to rush the Megapole here. Like, right there. Next turn. And that way we can level it up very quickly. Alright, we probably don't have to manual this, but let's just be sure. These guys are not a huge threat once we have our tier 2 gear on. So, we should be able to pretty easily kill one of them. We just focus all the ranged units on one, and then have the dredges attack the other two, so they don't get to use their beam attack. Yes, like you go to here and you go to here. Okay. Our damage level is still not super high. Wildwalker troops have pretty poor base damage. Wow. Big hit, and he landed his stun. That was really lucky. So we finish off the one who isn't stunned first. And that's it. You've just seen all of the attacks they will ever get. So that's pretty easy. There is going to be another spawn, though, isn't there? So we probably can't actually attack purple. We had to be ready for that. Where do I want to stand to be maximally ready for that? I guess right here? This is like central-ish. I do really need purple and blue to stay out of Chadhun. All right, so this turn we'll get our final retrofit. Have a modern-ish army. But it's turn 43. Oh, here we go. What's going to be the best way to deal with that? I guess we're going to come around this side. Okay, yeah, that's not too bad. It's turn 43, though, and my concern is that the AI might be moving toward Palladian and Adamantian weaponry at this point in the game. So we might not actually be in a good position to attack them, but I think our position's going to get worse for a little while rather than better. So as soon as we can move out of post and beam here, we should go for it. I hate this. I know he's going to run into my territory. I don't want to spend influence on the closed borders. But he may force our hand. I probably should have not moved my settler there. Okay, good. They chose to attack the army rather than the settler. I really appreciate that. Okay, these guys are a little bit more dangerous. So we have 4 range on the Dakari Rangers. 2, 3, 4. Yeah, this is fine. Everybody's got somebody they can shoot. In fact, the person who goes first should be here, so we can guarantee there'll be an enemy in this space when that happens. You attack here, and you attack there. This initiative on the hammers thing is really working out. Did their initiative order change? Oh, we only did 1 damage. Okay. Well, hopefully this is the end of that quest. And I think when it says in 1 turns, I think the check is at the beginning of turn 45, which means that we're good as long as nobody moves. As long as nobody has saved up points of movement for the purpose of using them after I hit the next turn button. Okay, so we'll put the megapole right here because we've already begun construction of this burrow, and that'll make it easiest. 14 turns. That's not great. I don't love that. You guys can move to dust. That'll shore up our dust problems. I think I just want you to found. Oh, I can't even give him the order to found while he's in my territory. I think that's kind of annoying. I wish that wasn't the case. We're also going to get some more money in Frida. I should probably move up the sewer system. Let's actually make that next. Okay, that'll help. Empire-wide approval. I should have popped my emeralds. Nah, that was a mistake. Should have popped the emeralds before settling the third city. Oh well, we'll live. We'll be okay. Now the question is, how aggressive do I want to settle? Do I want to pump out another settler right now? Because we could go to 5 regions very quickly. I think I'd like the city to grow a little bit, though. Maybe we should, well, there's not really a good place to put a burrow, because I founded this city with the idea that it wasn't going to expand very much. Since, you know, we took this, this powerful in the short term, not so good in the long term position. That said, we can still expand it, but I don't know that I want to for the approval effect. We definitely don't want to build a husbandry center here. You know, the city doesn't actually have a lot of meaningful, valuable things to do. So let us, when I guess, pop this Dakari Ranger out and just have it follow the main army, right? Okay, good. It looks like we are going to get some forward motion on our faction quest here. So at some point soon, we're given a quest to raise a new city center and new district to its level 2. Ooh, somebody just built the museum. So we may really be on the clock here as far as the megapole goes. Okay, yeah. So that just means any not our original city center. Could be Frida. Maybe Frida. We'll just do a standard triangle here. That being the case, it's Frida that probably wants the husbandry center. It's growing relatively quickly. We don't want it yet, because we want to stay on industry until we're done with all this stuff. But I think that's probably where that's going. Okay, you guys, yeah, settle that. Okay, so this is the time for threatening purple, basically. If we're ever gonna do it, we gotta do it now. I'm a little worried about pink settling up this way. It's part of the reason that I was thinking it might be a good idea to really push our settlements out. Unfortunately, we're gonna have some trouble equipping our troops with titanium for a while. We're not getting the titanium as quickly as I'd like, and we're going to want it for the alchemy workshops. And the alchemy workshops require a lot more titanium than, like, the central market requires glass steel, you know? Maybe we should just leave purple alone, I guess. My thinking here is that we have a number of minor factions that still need to be pacified. Maybe it's not in my best interest to spend all this effort going after purple. It always feels like you should attack your neighbor, but part of that is that you expect all of your neighbors to be claiming territory. When you have the cult nearby, maybe it's better to just expand normally. So I'm going to send this guy down to claim all these pearls. There's a ton of pearls that spawn around the capital. I hate this winter. Ugh. -1 industry winter. This is my least favorite winter. Well, shoot. I would love to take a city from purple and sue for peace. What do I think the odds of that are? How likely do I think that is to actually work? Alright, I don't usually do this, but I'm very torn, and I want to try some things. So we're going to make a save here, so that we can come back to it, and I'm going to just give some things a try. Yeah, this winter that removes industry from tiles is the worst. This is the worst thing. What is this? This is closed borders. That's the end of the free influence. We got a lot of good influence out of that, though. So what's the cost of declaring war on him right now? 56. That's very high. Why is it so high? Well, it's partially based on the number of cities you have, and partially based on the era that you're in, I believe. We have no modifiers, so that's just what it costs at this size at this time. Well, it's not that we can't pay it. I'm just kind of curious if we can do this, frankly. So he's got stalwarts. He does have Verdecki. Verdecki are good against ranged units, generally. My other concern is that he may just have enough troops that he can fight us on this front while also attacking our capital. That would be where this really falls apart. I don't think I want to attack 9 units with 100 fortifications. That's why we're going into siege mode instead of just attacking the city instantly. Oh, for a second there, I thought blue was going to stand in the bottleneck and make purple not able to hit us. Blue is kind of threatening us. I'm a little concerned about that. God, I hope this is a really short winter. Oh, he moved. Oh, no, he didn't move all of his armies out of range. I was going to attack if none of the armies were in reinforcement range, but this army still is, and I have no idea what's in it. So at this point, attacking seems a little foolish. Okay, this is a larger army of stalwarts and guys and stuff. What are you doing right now? Oh, he's going to get the pearls that I can't really afford to send anybody after. I see. Well, it's a bummer. I'm a little concerned that this army might attack us, because they can. We're in territory that is not our territory. And the AI loves to do that. When you declare war on somebody else, they sneak up and attack your armies. They'll never attack the AI's armies while doing that, because they hate the player. They hate the player very much. Alright, it's about time for this to turn into a thing. Can we move this guy into range? He's still in range of the city. Yeah, this thing where the AI is able to just produce this many units, it's a real problem. So should we attack? I hate attacking into fortification, but these guys have not attacked the capital yet, and we might be able to get peace out of them if we're able to take the city. My concern is that they will never, ever accept peace if they are sieging you. No matter how minor the city they are sieging or how bad the war is going for them on the whole, they just will not accept peace while they are sieging, because they think they're winning the war if they're sieging. Out of curiosity, how does he feel about the war right now? He feels like it is very much in his favor. What are the damage values of our units are such that what's his defense is 93. So his defense is higher than our attack, which means that we're not going to deal full damage very often. Not as often as I would like. He's got enough fortification, basically, that anytime we don't deal full damage, it's going to take us two hits to knock the fortification off of a unit before we start dealing damage to its hit points. But anytime we do deal full damage, we take the fortification off in one. Which means that attacking them this turn and attacking them next turn aren't really different when the attacks deal full damage. Pretty torn, but I think I want to try to wrap this up before he sieges Karendar. Okay. Now, we don't really have much to take advantage of in the way of cliffs or anything, but we do have a little bit of a natural bottleneck here. I think I want my hero in front of the archers, both because the archers have better range and because the hero's a little tougher. Is this how we want to stand? We want to take advantage of the forests, both for their offensive potential and for their plus defense. His attack is really low. So we have 63. On all of our frontline guys, we have 63 defense. And remember, some of them are going to have some... everybody's going to have some bonus morale from standing in a clump like this. So he's not going to deal very much damage to us. And despite the fact that Delvers have pretty bad initiative, we're actually able to stay above these guys because Broken Lords have really bad initiative. Alright, so I guess we pick a target and we focus hard. He's not bringing in the army. He chose not to reinforce with that army. Okay, we might actually be able to take the city in this attack then. That's very interesting. So, yeah, we focus hard. Pick a target, burn it. 138 defense with his morale is rough. Some of our guys are above that on attack, but not all of them. Well, I think we focus on this guy. You move to here and attack there. You plan to attack this guy. I wish I could give orders. I wish I could give orders on contingency. Like, I don't really want this... I want this guy's order to be moved to this space. My plan is going to be to just sort of herd them from the east to the west. But I can't give that order, as far as I'm aware. I can't give an order to move into a space that is currently occupied by an enemy. Or at least if I do, I don't know what will happen if the enemy's still alive, if he'll attack the enemy, or if he'll choose to do something else entirely. Get a nice circular attack. Okay, I thought we might be able to kill that guy in one turn. This is saying to me that we're definitely not going to be able to conquer this city then in one battle. We should come out ahead. But oh man, the circular attack is gonna be beautiful. Okay, this guy's the new target. Again, I wish I had a good way of signaling that I want you to attack this guy until this guy is dead and then change to that guy. He has 84 health. I mean, we should shoot him with everybody, because who knows how many times we're going to get, you know, cut in half. And oh, wow. Okay, they change targets to the appropriate target immediately. That's nice. So you can see what I was talking about here. Anytime that our units do 23 damage, they're not peeling the fortifications off in a single hit. Yeah, we're gonna lose that dredge. Is he gonna survive the turn? Okay, good, good, good. You get one more big, beautiful circular attack off. Please stay focused. So yeah, unfortunately, our units just do too little damage to take the city quickly, which means that Purple's going to be able to siege our capital, which means that in order to end the war, realistically, we're looking at... Hey, a stun! Nice. A stun, but then he dealt zero damage to everyone on his attack, which is less good. In order to end this battle, we're looking at... We take the city, and then we have to march our army back home and kill his siegers. And then, after he's down a city and he has none of our cities sieged, then we might be able to negotiate peace, depending on what his army score is relative to ours. This is the danger of conducting an early war, not the very earliest that you can possibly do it. I'd really like to focus on the stalwarts rather than the militia. And I think we want to focus on this guy, because this guy is stunned, right? I'm assuming speed zero is... For some reason, oh yeah, it shows up here. For some reason, it's not showing up on his card. Despite the fact that it has a space that is explicitly for status effects. Seems like that would be a good use. So I'd actually like you to do this. We get three targets with the circular attack if the Delver moves. Ah, that sucks. It took us three hits to peel his fortification. We're in really bad luck with the stuns here. Because our stun chance is like 30%, isn't it? Well, I think this archer is probably in trouble. Well, we can do a fall back. Actually, you can fall back to a forest base and still hit him, so do that. You're second, you're first. So we can do a little bit of rearranging here to move everybody into slightly more secure positions. Sadly, the hero is first. I'd like it if the hero were at the end so that he can kind of like fill the gap. Alright, we keep trying to kill this guy. That's a pretty good start. Damn it. Stop doing zero. Given the attack table, we're getting actually really bad random number generation here. We're getting completely boned. Because we should be dealing zero damage very rarely. Very, very rarely. Yeah, the attack table said 6% there. And 10% there. Why you didn't have orders to attack that guy? It took us three attacks to kill that guy because we hit a 6% and a 10% the turn after we hit a 10% and a 10%. That's some to be perfectly honest, that's some poor sportsmanship. They're attacking me. They moved the guy in the garrison out to attack us. Okay. They're probably including their reinforcement army this time, so this is actually going to be a little bit worse for us. Yep. Okay, so this is bad. This is what we learned. I think I don't really want people to move around a lot. this guy has three moves, so he can move into this forest. I mean, he can do that with two moves. So I don't really want somebody to be standing here. I think I may just accept that this ranger doesn't get to hit anybody this turn, but move to here, and we're going to try to, you know, fall back into this. Take the fewest possible casualties in the counter battle here. Yeah, so our damage, part of it is that our luck is some kind of incredibly bad, like unbelievably bad. But our damage is just too low to successfully war with purple. And again, our troops are in the wrong order here. I really wish that our initiative order was different. Well, we can fall back and minimize the casualties pretty well, I think. Come on with the zeros. If you went and if you took all the attack tables and did the math and just figured out what our average expected damage would be, I'm confident that we are maybe operating at 50% of that number, maybe even less. And again, like, this sucks because our hero is first. Our hero needs to fall back to here, but can't do it until after this guy's turn. So the bad ordering of our units is going to hurt us here. Oh my god, our damage is so bad. Yeah, hero's... Oh no, hero's not dead because they're refocusing. Oh no, hero might still be dead, actually. Okay. So this is our most defensible formation and the formation which leads to us having the best possible morale. Please, do not arbitrarily change your targets. Keep fighting the guy that we've been fighting. Oh no, they have a guy who has higher initiative than the rest of us. And he landed his stun, which is just insult to injury. Well, I don't know if we're all gonna die because I don't know if they have the attacks necessary to kill all of us. No, but it looks like they probably do. Are you kidding me with the zeros? Guys, just stop being bad. Shoot better. Shoot more good. Yeah, see, this is the reason I wanted to take up this kind of positioning, is that we can bottleneck them pretty well here. And yeah, I think attacking the Berdeki is probably the smart move. He has not great defense and not great hit points. And simultaneously, he's the most dangerous unit in their army, so. Alright, well that's the game right there. If we pursue the war with purple, we just lost. Because they will now attack our capital on the next turn. There's no way we can get peace out of them because they're... the differential in our army scores is better for them than it was when they were not willing to agree to peace. So that's what I figured, and that's why I was hesitant to enter the war. That's a shame. We missed our window is what happened. You can conduct a very successful military campaign right at the timing when you get access to the tier 2 weapons, generally. The tier 2 titanium and glass steel weapons. But we are way past that point. That point is somewhere in the late 20s, early 30s, probably. At this point, the AI is, first of all, going to have massive armies, like huge numbers of units. And secondly, depending on their technological progress and to some degree their faction, obviously, the Ardent Mages and Vaulters are going to be better at this than others. They may already have the beginnings of their titanium and or their adamantium and palladium stuff going. So, I'm glad I tried it, though. I think it's good to get out there and actually figure it out. But yeah, the war against these guys would be an embarrassing affair at this point. Now, if we got to play D, things would be a little bit different, and I think we'd probably be okay. This is the end of that. Let's try to pursue a strategy of aggressive expansion, I guess. We're probably not upsetting blue too much, especially if we had north and then west. I don't really want anybody but me to get this. Because this is back guarding this region, right? But I'm also not going to push for it too aggressively. I don't want to settle all around blue and then have blue freak out on us. Despite the fact that he only has one city, which might make you think that his production capability would be poor, he's still an endless AI. And, you know, they got different rules than the rest of us do. You need to step off. These are my pearls. Close borders? Yeah. So purple probably intends to declare war on us. But, like I said, things are going to play out a little bit differently if he has to come to our cities than if we have to go to his. And despite the fact that I said I would like to try to boat a little bit more, I'd like to try to navy a little bit more in this this game, the fact that we didn't get a city on the water until our third city, I think really hurts that that strategy. I think it was right to do things the way we did them, but I just think that we're probably not going to be able to get too much control of the water. Although, I guess we don't know that for sure that purple has access to the coast. We do know that blue doesn't, and we know that if pink does, it's the other coast. So actually, maybe getting to the water late isn't exactly a death sentence here. We might try to pick up some ship tech. I like boarding vessels a lot, but maybe we should just go straight to fire ships. I like boarding vessels a lot because I don't tend to fight on the water so much as scout and flee, which boarding vessels are definitely better at. Honestly, though, boarding vessels are not as terrible at combat as I think they sometimes get the rap for. There's a lot to be said for doing your damage up front. Wait, where am I being pillaged? Purple is pillaging one of my villages with enough fortification damage to take it down in 2 turns. Well, unfortunately, there's nothing I can do about that. I'm pretty sure that closing borders wouldn't stop them from doing that since they're on one of their spaces while they're doing it. That's just spiteful and shitty, but they're going to get away with it. And it's good dust for them. Like, it's not... Sorry, I said it's just spiteful, but it's not just spiteful. It is, like, advantageous. Return to this village with an army that contains a minimum of 3 minor faction units. Well, that would be easy enough to do, but it's also not that hard to just kill Silix. So I think that's what we're gonna do here. Let's kill these guys off. Okay. Somebody is in era 4? It's turn 50. We're 3 techs into era 2. So we're definitely still having problems. I think we can probably auto resolve that. Definitely still having problems keeping up on tech. Part of the issue is that we haven't built any of our sweet, sweet tech buildings yet, and a big part of that is that we have lower, like, empire-wide industry than I would like at this point in the game. Alright, let's put these guys down. Oh, I don't have my action point, right. Okay, we'll snap our hero back after we clear things out a little bit more. So we're getting science buildings up in Frida, that's really important. I really, really want to complete the Megapole. I think we'll get it. Oh, actually, we were pillaged by blue. It was a blue army. If I had tried that shit, purple would have attacked me. Now, what is this? Oh, we met red. They have a Skyfin in our territory. That's fine. I'm cool with that. 50 dust, pretty disappointing. This is the point in the game where we could be finding, like, Palladium and Adamantium. I was kind of hoping for something like that. Okay, so let's get some ship designs, huh? Like I said, I don't really love fire ships, but it is very frustrating to fight a large number of fire ships with boarding vessels. Sometimes you can get lucky. The vastly superior on-impact damage allows you to blow them away pretty fast. But if there's enough fire ships that the battle's going to go long, all your porting vessels will burn down. And then once you're actually engaging in ocean combat, then like subs become interesting because the subs are immune to the fire because they can just submerge to knock it off. And I think the subs are just flat immune to fire, but you know the flavor reason is that they can just submerge to knock it off. But maybe we need to pick up Imperial Highways, actually, before we do boats. Because our empire is starting to get pretty spread out, and there's a lot of forest between our cities, which means that there's a lot of turns spent walking from place to place. Alright, let's push on these. Do you have all your basic stuff done? Huh. Actually, that's right, we want to get the Husbandry Center up here, because we want to make this city our, Hold on, how many citizens do I actually need? So we can make an Abbey of Anomalies for one of the districts. Third winter is sometime soon. Probably not too far off. We have enough pearls to do that. So we need 8 population. And we're at 2 currently. Yeah, probably the Husbandry Center is worth building. But actually, let's push up to Fervent first. This gives plus food on Fervent, and being Fervent gives plus food, so seems sensible. Alright, I'll turn these guys around, attack this village, and then probably it'll be time to reassign our hero to one of our cities. This guy's just going to wait in the capital. This is probably worth running our hero out just for the amount of XP that he's gaining, though. Ruin search plus fighting. Alright. 3 Silix should be completely trivial. But Dredges actually took a lot of damage. I wonder if our ranged units were like spreading their damage out or something. Totally feasible. Alright, we're gonna keep looking around, but I think for now, like I said, this would be a good time to snap the hero back to this city to give it a little bit of a push. I think we'll just eat the small deficit for a couple of turns. Yeah, we're about to have our settler out. So let's have a look around and figure out what I want to settle. It's not inconceivable that we can just take this region immediately. Since we don't have to worry about blue like settling into the gap. We'll see. I am going to destroy this converted village. We're going to drop Blue's resource income by as much as possible. They're not going to like it, and eventually they're going to attack us, but I think it's important not to let them get too far ahead. Look at how big their city is. They built all these districts, and they still don't have a level 2 museum because they built their city wrong. Oh my god, this is taking forever. What was the quest I had here? Colonize the region. So I can still get that even though the village is converted? Really? That's interesting. What's up? A warning. Okay, so they intend to declare then. There's no reason for them to warn us right now, except that they can't afford a declaration of war because they've already closed their borders to us. That's the other thing that they might be trying to pay for. So I guess our army's coming back. So maybe we do want to settle this region to just take advantage of the questline that's available to us. Maybe this should be our next settle. It's going to cause some ruffling of feathers. Alright, we gotta search this ruin. Maybe we can probably afford to search that ruin too. And then we gotta head back, because it's going to be murder time. Alright, cool. 70 dust. I guess that's fine. Oh, there's a cliff. Yeah, let's not take the extra time. Do I want to destroy the village? I want to do the quest, but also I want Blue to not have resources. I don't know, hard to say. Okay, so next turn, Fritta will be fervent. We can start producing an alchemy workshop. We don't really need the glass steel extractor to go up quickly. We're nowhere near being able to afford a hero, right? Yeah. Our dust economy has definitely been an issue this game. I think we're going to go back home this way just to avoid having to walk through too much forest. On the whole, I actually think this game's going quite a bit worse than the last one, despite the fact that we have more territory. I think we got Building the Future done way earlier than we're going to get it done this time. Alright, I think we gotta settle near the anomaly, right? Well, settling near the anomaly means we only have 6 industry. Maybe it would be better to drop like here, get 12 industry, and then just plan to build out in a way that gives us the anomaly, but like, I don't love having a low industry city right on the border of an enemy. It's not a thing that you should never do. Sometimes it's worthwhile to do that if you have a lot of dust, because you can just rush the buildings. But I think our next research has to be an industry research. So apprenticeship registry and lumber mill are both great. Canal locks is also great. The canal system is very clearly the worst of these 4 buildings, but it's also the only one that doesn't require titanium. So let's go this way. Let's get hydrology. So we're a little pressed for titanium at the moment. Now we might want to have this guy wait until after turn 60 to settle. I'm not sure. Alright, we're about to get a big boost in our science rate. The megapole is finished. Alright, well, if purple declares on us now, I feel confident that we'll be able to at least construct units very quickly. Alright, yeah, let's get some important stuff going. Oh, I feel good about having this stuff done. Right, that'll be plus approval from leveling up the altar. And then building the bureau here will get us a little bit more plus approval and 25 more industry, as this city will probably be fervent and also very productive. Empire-wide approval is at 81%. We're working on a market here, and a market here, and a sewer system here, so we might actually be able to push empire-wide approval to fervent pretty soon. So if I do plan to keep these guys from settling just yet, maybe I want to keep them inside my border. What are we looking at as far as... It would be 400 to replicate this, and I think we want to. So yeah, we definitely don't want to settle. Settling would drive the cost of this way past what we can afford. And we're not going to destroy this village yet, because if we actually are going to get 15 titanium for settling the region, I want that to happen really badly. We can make great use of 15 titanium. Okay, somebody has a level 8 hero. That's a lot better than our hero. There's a sea monster, no surprise there. Actually, I don't think we want to run these guys too far south, though. Like, I want to be able to defend the capital, but purple doesn't really have any armies in attack position. I think they may have changed their mind. So we probably want this army to be up here so that we can attack the village if we need to after we do a little bit of the quest. Alright. So we gotta start getting Fritta built out now. Once it finishes the alchemy workshop. I think that takes precedence over right of way. We gotta get this quest moving, man. We are way behind. Alright, we're taking this. I like this Empire plan a lot. And then... now we want to settle. So let's have a quick look and make sure I'm not crazy. 412-36 versus 367-11. I mean, this is way better dust. Actually, this, even though this sacrifices a space, it's still better than this settle. 412-36 versus 312-47. Alright, we're gonna do it. We're gonna do the border settle. I don't love it, but the math is sound. Okay, so we maintain influence, we'll get 15 gold. I don't actually care about that, I don't think. Yeah, 15 gold wouldn't let us pop a booster. So let's demolish this now. Because we're not getting any benefit from this village. With it being converted. Alright, we got the thing that was important. How bad is our empire-wide approval now? Not too bad, actually. If we rush... I think this is totally worth spending the money for. Alright, we're about to have a reasonable titanium gain rate. We should send the army north, I guess. If purple's not threatening us, let's explore this region. We could be on, what, 7 regions here without really coming into contact or conflict with anybody over land. I don't think that we should ignore that. Look at this. We haven't really looked at Tame's resources too much, and a lot of the territory is pretty bad. But there is a spot here that's pretty fantastic. If we settle right there and then expand out here, and yeah, that looks really good for our next settle. Okay, let's get a lot of basic structures going. So Fritta needs to get to 8 population, or we need to chip in pearls to get access to, like, the Winterborough, which is a pretty good building. The winter could happen any moment now, at most 13 turns from now. In 13 turns, we probably will not even have 6 population. If I move everybody over without building the husbandry center, is that going to be good enough? Because we could take this time to start building burrows. Yeah, let's do that. So do I want a triangle like this, or like this, is the question. Oh, well, the city center has to be level 2. So it has to be, the city center has to be in the center of one of the sides. Okay, that makes that pretty simple. This looks like a pretty okay region. Like, this would be a fine settle, even though it's low forest. You get some river tiles and some anomalies. How far are we from having a city that's not building anything vitally important? Because obviously, I'd like to build settlers, but also we have to get valuable buildings done. Karandar could probably do it. We should probably move this up here. Alright, well, we don't exactly have a powerful war machine, but we have a pretty good economy in every way except for dust. Because, you know, your ability to create infrastructure and stuff is also part of your economy. Alright, 10 free titanium, not bad. We're not quite as starved as we used to be. Let's plan to do this so that we don't get attacked by Blue's army. I think for the most part we're just kind of like staying the course, right? Like, I know it's not fascinating to watch, but we're in a pretty good place. Alright, so now I think this is a good time to pick up a boat. But which boat? I usually go for these pretty heavy boarding vessel armies so that we can move around quickly and explore ruins quickly. I think that's what we should go for. You're likely to find the designs for the early ships in ruins. And with a boarding vessel, we can search more ruins. Basically, with the boarding vessel tech, we're more likely to end up with both boat techs than we are if we go for the fire ship first. We are definitely Empire faction questing slower than I would like. Let's move away from Blue's army. We should probably attack this village. I know, Blue's going to declare war on me any second now if I keep messing with them, but their army seems to be pretty busy. Let's actually, real quick... They're not at war with Purple, and we haven't actually met Pink yet. We should do that. We should endeavor to meet Pink. We could get to 8 regions if we settle here. Maybe we should turn the army around. Just ignore the fact that Blue's army might threaten us. I want to see what this region is like to see whether it's settleable. Because if we can settle this region next and then backfill these, we have a huge amount of territory to work with, which means a lot of resources, which means a lot of other things. You know, it's good, is the point I'm making. It's really good. Alright, so with Ishimlor's sewer being finished... We should be we're very close to fervency. We do need to pick up at some point here Imperial coinage. And any luxury resource purchases would push us over on approval, which would fix our dust problem. I'm hoping the trade will also fix our dust problem. This might be a very aggressive settle, but it's also potentially really powerful. Also, look at these tiles. I love river through forest as these guys. Like right here, we get an anomaly and a bunch of forest tiles and a bunch of river tiles. This would be a very powerful settle. All right, well, we're going to look into that a little more closely next time. Come back then to see if Purple does indeed declare war on us, if we do indeed make the incredibly aggressive settle, and if we are, in fact, capable of finishing our faction quest a little faster this game. And we'll see you then.